In this video, we'll go over some examples of applying and editing PaintShop Pro's pre-installed masks. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also download a written copy of this tutorial, along with sample images you can download to try out the steps yourself. PaintShop Pro comes with a few pre-installed masks, and the techniques in this video make use of masks that come from one of Corel's free content packs. This free download can be found by clicking the house icon. Once inside the welcome book, click Get More along the left, Creative Content along the top, and download and install the Creative Content pack. I'm starting with this image, which has a photo layer placed above a solid, flood-filled, dark red layer. The photo layer is active, so the mask I choose will be applied to the photo. I'm choosing Layers, Load Save Mask, Load Mask from Disk. I'm choosing the Edge Ripples mask, and I'll use the As Is option to keep the mask at its original size. The mask image is smaller than the photo, so the mask takes up just a small part of the top left corner. I want to keep the outer edges of the photo as a frame, so I'll use the Show All Mask option. This means that all parts of the photo outside the mask limits will show. When I click Load, here's the result. The mask appears in the top left corner, and the black areas of the mask block the photo, allowing the red layer to show through. To adjust the mask placement, I'll make sure the mask layer is active, and I'll activate the Pick tool. I'll adjust the limits of the mask, then choose Objects, Align, Center in Canvas. Now the border is even all the way around. Now say I want to eliminate some parts of the mask to show more of the photo. I can paint with white to show these areas. I'll activate the paintbrush, adjust the brush size with the Alt key and my mouse, and change the color to white. Now I can paint over what I want to remove from the mask. It's a little hard to see in the Layers palette, but the extra white paint now shows on the mask image here as well. Now say I change my mind about keeping the photo border. I can switch to black paint and carefully drag the mouse around the border. This blocks more of the photo, and the new black outline appears here as well. Or I can undo, set a light gray for the background fill, and use the selection tool to carefully select the areas I want to partially block. I'll select the top border first, and press Delete to replace this selected area with the background color. This makes the border partially translucent. I'll repeat for the other three parts of the frame, and now note the gray border in the mask image. Finally, if I want a softer mask, I can blur the edges a bit. With the mask layer still active, I'll choose Adjust, Blur, Gaussian Blur. I have Preview on Image checked, and a radius of about 6 makes for a nice, soft effect. For my second example, I'll start with this photo of a bride, placed above two layers that are not yet painted. I'll make the bottom layer the only displayed layer, and make it active. I'll choose a solid light blue color, and flood fill the layer. Now I'll turn on the middle layer and activate it. For this layer, I'll click the foreground swatch and choose a darker blue than what's used on the layer below. I'll also click Texture, click Add Texture, and choose this paper texture. I'll adjust the scale a bit. Textures are grayscale repeating images that act just like masks. When I flood fill this textured color, the black areas of the texture image are blocked, showing the lighter layer below. I'm now turning on the photo layer and making it active. I'll load mask from disk again, and this time I'll choose Edge Squares. The orientation is still as is, and this mask will hide all. So the entire photo will be blocked, except in the white and gray parts. With the mask layer active, and using the Pick tool, I'll move the mask to this corner and resize it. To make the bride fit inside her mask, I'll activate that layer and move and resize. The groom will go in the top left corner. I want to use the same mask at the same size, so I'll right-click on the bride's mask group layer and duplicate it. To switch out the photos, I'll open the organizer and drag the groom into one of the layer groups below the mask. The bride layer isn't needed in this group, so I'll right-click and delete it. Now I can activate the groom's mask layer and use the pick tool to move it to the opposite corner. I'll keep the mask at the same size. And to fit the groom to his mask, I'll choose that layer and move and resize it as well. The masks lend an interesting effect where they overlap. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on editing masks. The next video in this series will cover some options for creating new masks. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, please follow the link in the description below, which will take you to this tutorial page in Corel's Discovery Center. Here you'll find a written version of this tutorial, along with sample images you can download and follow along.